click on the subscribe button and remember to press the bell icon for regular notifications from A Digital Blogger. Hello friends, welcome to A Digital Blogger. Today we're gonna talk about some of the concerns regarding your Demat and trading accounts. A lot of users, especially beginner level users or intermediate level traders, what they can think is, well, I have opened a Demat account, what if I open a new one? Can I do that? In fact, they also go to the point thinking that, is it legal to open multiple Demat accounts? Well, we will discuss all of that and a lot more in this particular video. Let's get started. So let's start with the basic question, can you have multiple Demat or trading accounts? We'll not keep you hanging on this one. Yes, you can have two, in fact, multiple Demat accounts for that matter. Any number of Demat accounts as well will also work for you. It's as like as opening a bank account. It's your discretion how many accounts you want to keep, how many accounts you want to open, because it's at the end of the day, your money that's floating around. But some people ask this question, what is the point of having two Demat accounts? Well, there are multiple reasons, honestly, and it's a very subjective matter, varies from one trader to another. A lot of traders would want to have the best of both worlds. Now, both worlds imply a full service stock broker and a discount broker. For instance, quite a few traders prefer to have parallel trading accounts with both of these types. What happens is the setup is that the user can pick and choose based on the kind of trades he or she puts up. Based on that particular idea, the corresponding broker is selected and the overall trade is placed. You would know that a lot of aspects that come into picture when you go ahead and pick a stock broker. Well, things like brokerage, there are research, trading platforms, exposure, customer service, range of trading products, offline presence, the list goes on. Now, you can really cannot expect that a particular single stock broker will be able to help you out with this, the whole solution. It's not going to happen realistically. There are pros and cons in each broker, and in case you want more, well, you can go ahead and open two Demat or trading accounts with these two brokers. Furthermore, it makes complete sense to open two Demat accounts as long as you're serious about it. If you're a beginner, if you're here for testing waters, then yes, you can limit yourself to one trading or Demat account. But if you are somebody who wants to be here for a serious time, then go ahead and you can use and exploit that. There are few traders who want to keep Demat to trading accounts just to keep a segregation between the trading and investment practices. This keeps them aligned with their goals and there's less room for any confusion as well. So this is, again, it's a very subjective matter, but as long as the overall guidelines are concerned, there's not much of a problem for you. Talking about guidelines, some people think and ask that, is it legal to have multiple Demat accounts? So legality part comes into picture now. Well, absolutely, it is legal. Be it any regulatory body, be it SEBI, be it the exchanges, NSE or BSE, they don't really have a problem in you having multiple Demat trading accounts. But one thing you need to understand is that any regulatory body is not monitoring your specific trading account. What they are mapping is your PAN card. So PAN card works as the unique identifier. That is the key which is linked to your multiple trading accounts and multiple Demat accounts for that matter. So whenever you trade, irrespective of which Demat trading account you are using, the PAN card gets notified, and somebody who is going to track you, they are going to track you via that PAN card and see how many trades, how much monetary value you are putting in the stock market, and then the overall picture becomes clearer for them. So it is kind of obviously mandatory to link your PAN card, and that is where the SEBI or anybody who is going to track your account is going to do that in that way. At the same time, you need to understand that you cannot have two Demat accounts with the same stock broker. Now, a stock broker basically works as a depository participant. Now, there are different depositories. There is NSDL, there is CDSL. So these depositories have given licenses to multiple depository participants, which are invariably called stock brokers. So same PAN card cannot be used to open two Demat accounts with the same stock broker. So let's say if you have a Demat account with ICICI Direct and you've obviously given your PAN card for that, you cannot open another Demat account with ICICI. You'll have to choose somebody else. You have to choose Zerodha or 5paisa or IIFL or any other stock broker that works for you, but not ICICI Direct. Again, one thing that has been recently introduced is that you have to link your Aadhaar card as well. Now, this is something which is pretty recent and it's been made mandatory. There's a timeline to that, but obviously you have to link your Aadhaar card in the going future with your Demat accounts. Then the next obvious question is that are there any problems with having multiple Demat accounts? Now, since they're going to be positives, you can have a room for some negatives as well. Yes, there are some concerns and they should be aware of. For example, you have to pay annual maintenance charge for every Demat account you open. If you are a beginner, you should know that every stockbroker levies a specific amount as AMC or annual maintenance charge, which is obviously need to be paid annually. It could be in the range of 300 to 800 or 900 rupees, but this is an annual charge. But each stockbroker, almost 80% of stockbrokers levy AMC on their Demat accounts. You have to pay multiple AMCs in case you have multiple Demat accounts. Again, you have to track individual Demat accounts with the stocks kept or the trading accounts with the monetary balances kept. So again, you have to do this exercise because you're gonna have multiple accounts, and obviously there's not going to be a single app that's gonna collate everything and let you know single-handedly. Then again, if your Demat account stays unused for a longer period, then there is a possibility that the account may get frozen. Obviously the broker is going to give you some notifications before actually going ahead and take that step, but still it can happen. And if you want to reactivate that particular account, you need to go through the KYC process again. So these are some concerns. None of these concerns are grave enough, but still there are these concerns associated with having multiple Demat accounts, and our sort of idea is to make sure that you know that there is a negative side to it as well. Then a very few set of users ask this question that do I need to have multiple trading accounts for multiple Demat accounts so that I can map it one to one? Well, you don't need to do that. It's absolutely not mandatory. You can have one Demat account and you can have multiple trading accounts with different stock brokers, obviously, and you can link it back to that single Demat account that you have. For example, if you have a Demat account with the broker ABC and you have trading accounts with PKR and XYZ and ABC, obviously you have it. So three trading accounts can be linked back to your original ABC Demat account, and you don't need to open separate trading accounts with each of these, or rather separate Demat accounts with each of these different stock brokers. It's like going to a mall with a bag. Let's say you took a bag from your home and you're going to a shopping mall and you're visiting different stores. So whichever store you visit, whatever you buy from that store, you're putting in that particular bag of yours. So that bag works as the Demat account. Account and those different buyouts you are making from different stores are the stocks you're purchasing using multiple trading accounts. So think it from that perspective. And then finally, the safety question always comes into picture, and it's good. It should always come because it's your money at the end of the day. It should not be left out unsafe. Now, is it safe to have multiple trading accounts? Well, the answer is yes to an extent, simply because, for example, if you have just one trading account and, for example, it's not going to happen, but for example, that particular stock broker which you're having your trading account with goes bankrupt, goes out of business. Now, what happens to your money? Obviously, it's going to come back, but it's going to take some time and it's not going to come back completely. So there is a risk associated there, and it is with every broker. It's not that it's going to come up with a specific broker or set of brokers. So if you have multiple trading accounts, so your overall monetary balance is actually bifurcated. It's divided between different stock brokers, and in that case, even if one of them goes bankrupt, your rest of the balance stays intact. It is actually more safer. So I wouldn't say it's safe, it's safer to have multiple trading accounts. So these are different questions that we have sort of heard from different users through multiple channels, and we hope that we are able to answer these concerns in the most detailed manner. However, in case you still have any questions, any queries regarding your Demat or trading account or anything else as well, feel free to write that up in the comment section below, and we will be hoping to answer that questions as soon as we can. So that's it for the video. You can actually check out this link here, adigitalblogger.com/freestockbrokersuggestion, where we can help you out with selecting a stock broker that matches exactly with your requirements. Even if you're a beginner or an intermediate level trader or a seasoned investor, if you are still confused which stock broker matches with your requirements, put in those requirements in the form and we will be answering you as soon as we can again. So thank you so much again for watching this video. We hope you liked it. In case you did, please go ahead and like that video, share that video, subscribe to our channel, A Digital Blogger. Thank you so much again for watching this. Bye bye.